Yeah, girls can do it too.
Teaching construction, and this was going right down the same pathway, so I thought what better way to help bring this and promote this with girls than to help with NAWIC's Magic Camp. Some of the biggest rewards about being a camp volunteer is this is my fourth year doing the Magic Camp, and I've seen some of these girls that were ninth graders that are now seniors, and some that have graduated and are coming back, and to see how this can improve their self-esteem is just amazing. To see some of these young women out here that have gone from being young girls to strong young women that are going into the construction industry. It's really amazing. The more people that volunteer, it's just, these girls are like sponges. So whatever information you have to give them, just come out here and talk with them and share with these girls. And it's absolutely amazing because they just truly want to just soak up any information you have. And they're so eager and willing to learn. I would say to any trade representative that wants to come back out is just bring your knowledge, even if it's not to what specifically they're doing, bring that knowledge and share that with them and show them what you've been doing in the industry and that they can be a part of it. That's the best thing for these girls. Let them know that they can.
This is our fourth year of Magic Camp, and I guess what makes it so magical, it's not just about the construction, it's about the transition of these girls. They come in maybe a little bit hesitant to try some of the skills that they've seen in their classes. But then when they're out here surrounded by their friends, their peers, they feel a lot stronger. Every year we think about what is the project going to be, and it doesn't really matter because it's what happens when they are building that is the magic. And I'm just so incredibly proud of each and every one of them.
I've been involved in Magic Camp for 3 years, and the returning women, seeing how they reapply the skills that they learned their first year and how they bring along the people with less experience than they have, you watch them mature as individuals and you watch them gain some leadership skills, and it's a great program. I enjoy watching the girls learn to do things, and when they successfully do something, the smile that they get and the satisfaction that they get gives me satisfaction. Construction hasn't had enough women in it. As long as I've been in it, there haven't been enough women, and I want the future to have more women.
One of the rewards is just seeing the girls, first of all, how they work together as a team. And when I see them use the power tools at such a young age, that alone just chills me. And I think about how I did not have the opportunity to experience such a tremendous thing. Seeing them so young and so motivated, it's only inspiring.
I've been in the business almost 30 years, and based on the fact that there's not been any females in the low voltage side or the high voltage side as far as men are concerned, it was easier for me to go ahead and start showing what we do. It's nice to have women and females volunteer. Part of what we do is to have that next leadership, that next step of girls coming in. Best opportunity to make sure that our future has a big, huge part of setting up for the next future, my daughter's future to the next daughter's future. I think that's the best thing about mentoring, is we actually set up something that girls can actually say down the road that they've learned from somebody that's been in the trade. It's not just doing it on their own. They've actually had some experience teach them.
Magic Camp has kind of become our favorite project because it's unique. It relates more to the construction industry than just showing up at the end of the high school, which most high schools want us to just come out and talk about the opportunity 2 weeks before seniors graduate. This helps us meet students from freshman to senior year, and it is related to construction. And we were part of helping the school get started in the beginning, so we just continued on. Young people today don't understand, if they go through my apprenticeship program, when they turn out as a journeyman, they've earned 56 college credits. Through Palomar College. If they get another 18 units, they have their AA degree, and it's paid for by working. They don't have to get school loans. They learn just basics, how to read a tape measure, how jobs are sequenced, what construction's about. If they've got a desire to work with their hands and get into things, you know, there's Magic Camp's great because you get all the different aspects. You get some carpentry, you get the tile work they're doing over here. We build you a little birdhouse and show you kind of the aspects of what project management's about. You have a lot of speakers come in and give you a wide range of experience.
Above all, I've learned a lot of leadership skills to the point to where, you know, I can tell people what to do, and I've learned that it takes more than just one person to be able to put something like this together. You have to be able to set your differences aside, and you have to be able to go through the workday without arguing with someone, because in the end, they're going to be the ones helping you.
Well, this year, it's my fourth year, and it's just been fun all the way. Meaning you would say, I can't do that, and then being able to say, I built that. You actually learn something new every year, and you're able, like before, to use your skills every day. Living in a world where it's mostly guys in the construction industry, you look to a guy sometimes to help you build something, to help you fix something. I mean, being a girl, we need these skills. Need to learn to rely on ourselves.